But this is going to be a case, pretty quick one. It's a case of onychomycosis or fungal infection of the toenail. That the nail is so hypertrophic and so big, she can't really cut it, so it grew to a very large size, as you're going to be able to see. And then she stubbed it this morning, making it partially avulsed. At this point, there's no way in trying to repair this. We just numbed her up and removed the nail. Then as the nail grows, then we can treat the onychomycosis to prevent it from happening to the other nails. This might actually be the best thing that happened for this patient, because removing that nail and letting it grow a new one would have been the optimal treatment anyway for the onychomycosis. So they can put you on the medicine for the fungus, so that hopefully that new nail growing up and out won't have that.
First, I'm gonna check to see how numb you are. Okay. I'm gonna touch you with the blade. If it's pain, you let me know. This is dented. Okay. First thing, I'm gonna just drain the pus that's on the side here, and then we'll get to the other part.
But you know, the car wrecks and stuff like that, it's the worst ones were the burn victims, people who got burned up, and that was, and it kind of ran in a series with us. You know, you go out on one and the next day you're doing the same thing again.
How's that, like just different patient but just the same scenario?
I mean, we had let's see, one shift, a guy was working on his car, trying to get it started and pouring gasoline down the carburetor, and it backfired and burned both of his arms pretty good. And then the next shift, some lady brought in her little boy, 3-year-old boy. He was playing in the backyard. She had a pan of hot grease and was going to throw it outside, open the back door, and threw it on his back. You know, and then... right after that, two guys got in a wreck. They're right down the street from the station, and both of them got burned up. I mean, they were still alive when we got to them, but they both died the next day. And that was, I mean, seeing somebody burn that bad, you know, they were burned over like 100% of their body.
Yeah. All the way to the base. I'm just taking that out.
Yeah, I used to, like I said, when I was in the Army, I had a lot of trouble with him doing toenails.
Yeah, I used to get him a lot when I was a kid. Eventually, my mom told me not to cut him so close to the skin.
Yeah.
Just to leave them just outside and squared. You know, a lot of people try to curve them like the ones in your hand, but toes are not meant to be like that. That's why the toenail clippers are actually different. If you notice, the hands are more curved.
Yeah.
The one for the feet are more flat, because you're supposed to leave them flatter. If you try to cut down, then when the nail starts growing back, see, that's the nail we took out. So when we... what was I saying? When you cut it back, then it starts growing. It grows into the skin, and that's when they become ingrown.
Yeah.
Just clean it up.
Braces, okay. I'm ready. I'm ready, so I'm done. Okay. Yeah, I didn't feel a thing.
Yeah. That's great.
And one, I cut that out a long time ago. It's probably growing them out better now. But
This came because I was running around town doing errands and I wound up slamming my toe when I was walking around. I had to pull out a little piece that was sticking out of the side. And I'm guessing that's kind of like the biological safeguard so the toenail doesn't grow outwards. And then the nail decided to grow out. Uh-huh. Okay, so the full procedure includes cleaning the area.
Oh, wow. You're going to teach us. Perfect. Go ahead. I love it.
I'm guessing from the format.
All right.
That's a cleaning for the outer layer, correct?
The skin.
Stop infection from getting in from the...
We just don't want to introduce any new infection. I mean, it's already infected, so yeah, it's not...
Any new infections, foreign bodies from getting in, that's basically the clean so that you can then do the numbing medication, I would hope.
Right. So we're going to go with the numbing over here, which is an area that's really not infected, so we certainly don't want to introduce any new infection over there.
Perfect.
All right. So, on the count of three... There's the pinch, okay? One, two, and there we go. And you inject enough, like 1-2 cc's. And you do a slow injection, helps with the pain.
Hallelujah.
And we give it a minute or so to numb. We can talk. So let's talk about this kit over here. I got this out of Amazon, actually. It's a body tools toe kit. What it has is a nail lifter, so this allows to not traumatize the tissue underneath. It's kind of a flat thing that allows to lift off the nail off. So if you happen to have this at home and you could work at it, what you would do is what I was saying. When it's early on, not this bad like you were, but when it's early on, you can start trying to pull this outside and away like that, trying to lift the nail. You would introduce it just underneath and kind of start lifting. And when you do that, you take a cotton, little piece of cotton, and you try to push it underneath. That way it keeps it elevated enough. Yes. That way as the nail starts growing, it grows out. So I don't recommend you going on deep, but all you do is kind of just slightly pulling the skin away and lifting that nail. How does that feel? Are you hurting right now?
I feel basically nothing.
Basically nothing. So you see that? All I'm doing is trying to lift that nail away from the skin. So that's what you would do at home. Try to save you from coming to us.
If Lidocaine came, 10 out of 10. We'll numb again.
So now that we lift, I'm just grabbing that nail so it doesn't come out. I'm going to use this tool to get in there and cut.
I'm very glad your index finger, is blocking my side of it. Otherwise, my brain might actually react to it.
And that's that. See that how it came up? So that's the nail. And this is where the silver nitrate sticks come. So what we want to do is burn the nail matrix so that nail doesn't grow back.
Cauterizing it so the cells can't be produced. It's a dead cell layer then.
And then hopefully it will never go back. And here's the procedure itself. We start by using some iodine solution to sterilize the area. And I go in between each toe and all the way around it. Squish. Here I am getting ready the lidocaine. We usually use lidocaine 1% or bupivacaine, which lasts longer. Medicine. Initially, what we're looking at is me trying to do a digital block. Basically, we're trying to hit the nerve on the side of the toe as the nerve comes through. We also put some local lidocaine at the distal toe just to make sure he's nice and numb for the procedure. Necessary. Here we use a forceps to do blunt dissection going underneath the nail on the side of the ingrown toenail. The nail is too hard for the scalpel, so I go ahead and get some scissors and start getting underneath the nail and cutting the nail. The nail's pretty hard, so I have to get in there and cut a little bit at a time. Of course, I don't want to injure the nail bed underneath. I just want to try to get the nail without injuring the tissue underneath. Injuring that tissue will create more swelling and more pain once the numbing medicine wears out. And here I am cutting closer and closer to the base, trying to lift up. You can see, if you look in detail, the forceps already has, you know, 3/4 of that nail. I'm just trying to cut the final piece very carefully If you go in too deep, then you're going to go and cut the toe itself. So I'm going from the inside out, just a little bit at a time. It seems like I got it there, and I'm ready to pull out. And there comes the moment of truth. I use the force and just kind of pull the nail right out. You can see the piece comes out of the forceps. Now I'm just making sure I grabbed all of it